हेलो स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ वरेकर एन फ्रॉम एशियम कॉलेज कराड़ी। वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड अ टॉपिक मैट्राइसेस। इन दिस टॉपिक वी स्टडीड हाउ टू फाइंड द इनवर्स ऑफ ए मैट्रिक्स बाय यूजिंग कॉलम ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड रो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी हाउ टू फाइंड द इनवर्स ऑफ ए मैट्रिक्स बाय यूजिंग एडजॉइंट मेथड। So for that we have to know two concepts, that is minor and cofactors. So first is minor. We just recall this point, that is minor. This minor you studied in 11th standard. What is the definition of a minor? Minor of an element Aij of a determinant is the determinant obtained by deleting ith row and jth column in which the element aij lies. Minor of an element aij is denoted by mij. That means we have to eliminate corresponding row and column of that point. Suppose there is a point A11, so we have to eliminate first row and first column. You will get the minor of that element. That minor is denoted by Mij. So there is some example. Find the minors of the elements of A is equal to 1, minus 1, 2, 3, 0, minus 2, 1, 0, 3. We have to find its minors. So first element is A11 is equal to 1. Its minor M11, for that we eliminate first row and first column. If we eliminate first row and first column, we have a determinant 0, minus 2, 0, 3. If we expand this determinant, its value is 0. Again, minor of second point, that is A12, that is minus 1. Its minor, to find its minor, we eliminate first row and second column. So eliminate first row and second column, we have a determinant 3, minus 2, 1, 3. If we expand this determinant, we will get 11. Then third is 2. This point is A13. So its minor M13 is equal to, we have to eliminate first row and third column, its determinant is 3, 0, 1, 0. So here, if we expand this determinant, we get 0. Then next point is A21, that is this point, which is 3. So we have to eliminate its corresponding row and column. We have to give one minus 1, 2, 0, 3. If we expand this, we have minus 3. Then A22 point is 0. We eliminate its corresponding row and column. We have given 1, 2, 1, 3, which is equal to 1. If we expand this, its value is 1. Then next is A23 means that's minus 2. Eliminate its corresponding row and column. We have 1, minus 1, 1, 0. Here. So if we expand this, that is 0 minus of minus 1, which is plus 1. Then A31, this is third row, first column. So minus 1, 2, 0, minus 2. And its value is 2 minus 0, that is 2. Then 3, 2, that is third row, second column. 1 minus 2 is minus 2. And 3 into 2, that is minus 6, so minus 2 and minus 6, minus 8. Then 3, 3, we have to eliminate third row and third column. We have 1, minus 1, 3, 0. 1, minus 1, 3, 0. If we expand this, we will get 3. In this way, we find the minors. Then next is cofactor. What is cofactor? Cofactor of an element Aij of a determinant is given by minus 1 raised to I plus j into Mij, where Mij is the minor of element Aij. एंड को फैक्टर ऑफ एन इलिमेंट ए आई जे इज डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल ए आई जे और इट इज डिनोटेड बाय सी आई जे कैपिटल सी आई जे. एम आई जे इज द माइनर. इफ वी मल्टीप्लाई एम आई जे टू माइनस वन रेस टू आई प्लस जे वी विल गिव को फैक्टर. सो इट्स एग्जाम्पल फाइंड द को फैक्टर्स ऑफ द इलिमेंट्स ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू दिस इज द मैट्रिक्स एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड इट्स को फैक्टर. To find the cofactor, firstly we have to find its minors, that is MIJ. Firstly we have to find its minors. So we have first minor, that is minor of M11, that is this element, minor of M11 which is minus 3 and 0, so it is minus 3. Then cofactor, its cofactor is A11, which is equal to formula minus 1 raised to I plus J. Here is 1, 1, so here 1 plus 1 and that MIJ, MIJ is minus 3. So minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 which is 2, so minus 1 square which is plus 1, plus 1 into minus 3, that is minus 3. Then M12, first row and second column. So, minus 2, 5, minus 2, minus 1. If we multiply this or expand this determinant, we get 2 and here is plus 10, that is 12. Then again we use this formula A12. So, here minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 and MIJ is 12, which is equal to minus 12. Then M13, first row, third column. Minus 2, 3, minus 2, 0, minus 2 into 0, that is 0, 0, minus of minus 6, that is plus 6. So here is plus 6. So A13 is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 3 into 6, which is equal to 6. Then M21, second row, first column, that is minus 1 into minus 1, 1. And 0 into 2 is 0, 1 plus 0, that is 1. So A21 is equal to minus 1 raised to here 2 plus 1 and into MIJ, that is 1. So here is minus 1. Then M22, M22 is equal to second row, second column. This is minus 1 and this is plus 4, minus 1 and plus 4 which is 3. So minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2, so here is 3 into 3 which is equal to 3. Then M23, this is second row, third column. So 1 into 0, that is 0. And 2 into minus 1, that is minus 2 into minus 1, that is 2. That is 0 minus 2, which is equal to minus 2. So minus 1 raised to 2 plus 3 into minus 2 is equal to 2. Now M31, third row, first column. Here minus 5 and here minus 6, which is minus 11. So minus 1 raised to 3 plus 1 into minus 11, which is equal to minus 11. Then M32, which is equal to 9. M32, third row, second column, this 5 and plus this 4. So here is 9. So minus 1 raised to 3 plus 2 into 9, which is equal to minus 9. And then M33, M33, third row and third column. This is 1 into 3, that is 3, minus 2, which is 1. So, minus 1 raised to 3 plus 3 into 1, which is equal to 1. So, this is our cofactor. These are the minors and cofactors. For minor, we eliminate corresponding row and column. And for cofactor, we use formula minus 1 raised to I plus J into MIJ. This is your previous knowledge. So, you know that. Minors and cofactors. Then next is inverse of a matrix or adjoint method. Inverse of a matrix by adjoint method. So what is adjoint? What is adjoint of a matrix? So definition of a adjoint of a matrix, the adjoint of a square matrix A is equal to Aij of order m by m is defined as the transpose of the matrix capital Aij of order m by m, where capital Aij is the cofactor of the elements of Aij for all I and j. And this adjoint of a matrix A is denoted by Adj, that is adjoint of A. So what is the definition of adjoint of a matrix? suppose we have given any matrix A. Firstly, we have to find its minor. Then we will find its cofactor. After finding cofactor, we will give a matrix of cofactor. If we take a transpose of that matrix of cofactor, then we will get adjoint of that. That means matrix of cofactor. What is matrix of cofactor? This is the cofactors of that element. That is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, and A33. Then what is adjoint of A? We have to find its transpose. That is change its row by column. That is first row right here as a first column. Second row right here as a second column. Third row right here as a third column. This is called adjoint of A. So how we will find adjoint of A? Firstly find minors, then find cofactor, then these cofactors write in a matrix form and take its transpose. We will get adjoint of A. This is very easy. Then next is inverse of a matrix, square matrix by adjoint method. There is a step to find the inverse of a matrix by adjoint method. So first step is find minors of the element. Firstly, we have to find the minor of the elements, minors of the element of that corresponding matrix. Then second, we have to find the cofactor of that elements of a matrix. Then find adjoint of a matrix. How we find adjoint of a matrix? After finding cofactor, we get a transpose of that matrix, we will get adjoint of the matrix. And lastly, we use formula of A inverse. What is formula of A inverse? A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint A. A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. This is the formula of finding A inverse by adjoint method. For this, we have to find adjoint of A. In this formula, we put value of adjoint of A and determinant of A. We give value of A inverse. This is the adjoint method. So start with some examples. The first example, this is find the inverse of a matrix minus 1, 5, minus 3, 2 by adjoint method. Find the inverse of a matrix minus 1, 5, minus 3, 2 by adjoint method. The solution, firstly, we write here matrix A. A is equal to minus 1, 5, minus 3, 2. Then its determinant of A. Determinant of A is equal to, just write this matrix into determinant form. That is determinant of minus 1, 5, minus 3, 2. If we expand this, this multiplication is minus 2. This multiplication is minus 15, minus minus get plus. So here plus 15. Which is equal to 13, this is not equal to 0. So A inverse exists. Now we have to find minors and cofactors. Our first step is find minor and second step is find cofactor. So we find here minors and cofactors. What is M11? M11, eliminate corresponding row and column, we will get 2. M12, first row, second column. So here is minus 3. M21, second row, first column, so here is 5. M22, second row, second column, so here is minus 1. So what is A11? A11 is cofactor. So its formula is equal to minus 1 raised to 2, 1 plus 1. And here is M11. What is M11? M11 is 2. So right here 2. So minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1, which is plus 1, into 2, which is equal to 3. Then A12 is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2. And here is M12, which is minus 3. Here minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2, which is minus 1. Minus 1 and minus 3, which is 3. Then A21 is equal to minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1. That means here is minus 1. Minus 1 into 5, which is equal to minus 5. Then A22 is equal to minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2, here is plus 1, plus 1 into minus 1, which is equal to minus 1. So दीज आर दी कोफैक्टर्स. नाउ राइट दिस कोफैक्टर्स इन मैट्रिक्स फॉर्म. सो कोफैक्टर मैट्रिक्स इज इक्वल टू हियर 2, 3, -5, -1. So we have to find adjoint. What is adjoint of A? Take a transpose of this matrix. So write first row as a first column, second row as a second column. Now A inverse, write the formula. A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. So 1 upon, what is the value of determinant of A? We find out here, that is 13. And what is the value of adjoint of A? Is here, that is 2, -5, 3, -1. So this is our inverse of given matrix. Then next example, find the inverse of a matrix 2, -2, 4, 3 by adjoint method. Method is same as the previous example, that is, firstly, let A is equal to given matrix, that is 2, -2, 4, 3. The determinant of A is equal to determinant of 2, -2, 4, 3. We expand this determinant, 2 into 3, that is 6, minus of -8, which is equal to 14. And this value is not equal to 0, so A inverse exists. Now we have to find the minor set cofactors. Minor, eliminate M11, eliminate first row and first column. First row and first column, we will get 3. M12, first row, second column, we get 4. M21, second row, first column, we get -2. M22, second row, second column, we get 2. Now formula A11, what is formula? -1 raised to 1 plus 1 into M11, which is 3. So its value is 3. Then A12, -1 raised to 1 plus 2, 4, which is equal to -4. A21 is equal to -1 raised to 2 plus 1, -2, which is equal to 2. And A22, which is equal to -1 raised to 2 plus 2 into 2, which is equal to 2. In this A11, A12, A21, A22, without writing this formula, if you have to able to write the answer directly, then write it 3, -4, 2 or 2. Without using this formula, we find directly this answer. If this addition 1 plus 1 or 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1, 2 plus 2, if this addition is even, then M11 kept as it is for A11. And if this addition, that is 1 plus 2, is odd, then change the sign. If there is minus, then write in A12, that is plus. If there is a plus, then write here minus. Here is minus, so here is plus. This is the direct method. Then write these cofactors in a matrix form. A11, A12, A21, A22, 3, minus 4, 2. Now adjoint of A, make a transpose of this matrix, that is 3, -4, 2, 2. So its inverse, formula is A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. So A inverse is equal to 1 upon 14 into this adjoint of A. This is our second example. Now next example, find the inverse of a matrix 1, 0, 0, 3, 3, 0, 5, 2, -1 by adjoint method. A is equal to given matrix 1, 0, 0, 3, 3, 0, 5, 2, -1. Then write this matrix into a determinant form. Then determinant of A is equal to 1, 0, 0, 3, 3, 0, 5, 2, -1. So its value, expand this determinant. Now here this is a lower triangular matrix. This is a lower triangular matrix, right? So if the matrix is upper triangular or lower triangular or the diagonal matrix, then how we expand this matrix? Just multiply the diagonal elements. 1, and minus 1. Just multiply the diagonal elements. You directly give a value of determinant of A. No need to expand this determinant. For upper triangular matrix, lower triangular matrix and diagonal matrix and also scalar matrix. So here we multiply the diagonal elements, that is 1, 3 and minus 1, which is equal to minus 3. This value is not equal to 0, therefore A inverse exists. Then find its minors and cofactors. So minor M11, here we write here directly M11, first row, first column, that is minus 3 and 0. So here is minus 3. Then M12, first row, second column, minus 3 and 0. So here is minus 3. Then M13, first row, third column, this is 6 and this is 15. So here is minus 9. M21, second row, first column, this is 0 and 0. So here is 0. M22, second row, second column, minus 1 and 0. So here is minus 1. M23, second row, third column, 2 and 0. So here is 2. 31, third row, first column, 0 and 0. So here is 0. 32, third row, second column, 0 and here also 0. So here is 0. M33, third row, third column. So here is 3 minus 0, that is 3. What is A11? A11 minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into this minus 3, which is equal to minus 3. Here, if the addition of these two elements, 1 plus 1, if this addition is even, then write this minor as it is here in cofactor. And if this addition 1 plus 2, that this addition is odd, then just change the sign. So check here, if there is a A11 means addition is even, so minus 3 right here as minus 3. A12 odd, so minus 3 as 3. A13 even, so minus 9 as it is. A21, this is odd, so 0 as it is 0, this is signless. So A22, this is even, so right as it is. This is odd, so 2 becomes minus 2 here. This is even, 0, 0, as it is. And 3, 3 means this is even, so 3 right here as it is. This is the simplest method. No need to write this formula. Then, write this cofactor in a matrix form. We will get minus 3, 3, minus 9, 0, minus 1, minus 2. 0, 0, 3. So what is the adjoint of A? Adjoint of A is equal to, make its transpose, write first row as a first column, second row as a second column, and third row as a third column. So what is the formula of A inverse? A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. We find the value of determinant of A already, so this value is minus 3 and this is the adjoint of A. This is our example. Then next example, find the inverse of a matrix 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 5, 2, 4, 7 by adjoint method. So write this matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 5, 2, 4, 7. Then write this matrix into a determinant form. We have to expand this matrix. So expand this matrix. 1 into 7 minus this 20. Then minus 2 into 7 minus 10. Then plus 3 into 4 minus 2. If we solve this, 7 minus 2, that is minus 13 here, minus 13. Here is minus 3 and minus 2, that is plus 6 here, plus 6. And here is 6. So minus 13 plus 6 plus 6, that is minus 13 plus 12, that is minus 1, which is not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Now minors and cofactors, find minor M11, eliminate first row, first column, 7 minus 20, which is minus 13. Then 1, 2, first row, second column, 7 minus 10, which is minus 3. 1, 3, first row, third column, 4 minus 2, which is 2. Then M21, second row, first column, that is 14 minus 12, which is 2. Then 2, 2, second row, second column, 7 minus 6, which is 1. Then 2, 3, second, third, so 4 minus 4, which is 0. 3, 1, third row, first column, 10 minus 3, which is 7. 3, 2, third row, second column, 5 minus 3, which is 2. Then 3, 3, third row, third column, 1 minus 2, which is minus. Now this addition is even, so minus 13 as it is. This addition is odd, minus 3 become 3. This is even, so 2 as it is. This is odd, so 2 becomes minus 2. This is even, so 1 as it is 1. This is odd, so here is 0, so write 0 as it is. 3, 1, this is even, so 7 as it is. 3, 2, this is odd, so 2 becomes minus 2. And this is 6, so that means even, so minus 1 as it is minus 1. These are the minus and cofactors. Now we have to write these cofactors in matrix form. So cofactors in matrix form, we write here, that is minus 13, 3, 2, minus 2, 1, 0, 7, minus 2, minus 1. Now we have to find its adjoint. So make its transpose. Write first row as a first column, second row as a second column, third row as a third column. So A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. What is the value of determinant of A? Which is minus 1. And this adjoint of A, if we multiply minus 1 to each and every element of this, then this minus 13 is 13. This minus 2 is 2. 7 is minus 7. 3 is minus 3. 1 is minus 1. Minus 2 is 2. 2 is minus 2. 0 as it is. And minus 1 is 1. So this is the value of our inverse of a matrix of given matrix. Then next is the points which is useful for JET and CET. The properties of adjoint of a square of a matrix. These properties are very useful for CET as well as JE. Using this property, we solve directly or we find out the direct answer. So first property, what is first property? That is A into adjoint of A, which is equal to adjoint of A into A. Its value is always equal to determinant of A into identity matrix. Determinant of A into identity matrix. This is very important property. Then second, if determinant of A is equal to 0, if determinant is, that means the matrix is, if matrix is singular, then A into adjoint of A, its value also is equal to 0. Then third, if we find the adjoint of A and after that we will take its determinant, then it is equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1. Then adjoint of determinant of AB is equal to adjoint of B adjoint of A. Then adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of determinant of A raised to n minus 2 into A. This and this, if just here multiply by A and we take twice of the adjoint here. Then next, adjoint of A transpose is equal to adjoint of A of its transpose. Then adjoint of A raised to m is equal to adjoint of A raised to m, bracket raised to m, where m belongs to, m is any natural number. Then adjoint of K into A, then K get outside, that is K raised to n minus 1, adjoint of A. Then next, A is a symmetric matrix. If A is a symmetric matrix, that is Aij is equal to Aji, then adjoint of A is also a symmetric matrix. If A is a diagonal matrix, if A is a diagonal matrix, then its adjoint also a diagonal matrix. If A is a singular matrix, then determinant of adjoint of A is equal to 0. A is a singular matrix, therefore determinant of adjoint of A is equal to 0. Its value is 0, so that's why this becomes 0. So this is our lecture. In this lecture we studied how to find the inverse of a matrix by using adjoint method. Thank you.